Rocket, roll, 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 roll. regarding your motives in the Cape Canaveral crash. Is that then or nothing?
It puzzles me so. It puzzles me so. It puzzles me so. It puzzles me so. It puzzles me so.
Sunday night's chicken in the Walt Disney hour. Traditionally.
Yeah, but there's nothing on CBC right now, so.
It's a world of love, it's a tape.
You took the 60 minutes? They got rid of 60 minutes? Well, they didn't get rid of 60 minutes. But they eschewed the option of 60 minutes.
Who did?
These people.
Oh, I see. Oh, tonight, yeah.
It's okay. They were playing a show.
They were all stories that you knew before, anyway. Andy Rooney's almost retired.
This is a tradition we've started, and we feel so good about it. Also, as an opportunity to play with some of our great musical friends over the years and have them up here. We've had Ron Sexsmith and the Rio Statics and Aerosmith and
a young Michael Dankert.
Leah Pinsent, Gordon Pinsent.
One year we had Pierre Trudeau up doing a speaking thing. Sort of a comedy bit that he was working up. Sort of fell flat, but it was good that he came.
Yeah.
Supported the
shows us.
I don't know. Justin was in the pool and someone handed me some tie stick or hash. I smoke what I'm given, man.
So we've had a ball here the last couple of nights, and we're gonna play some songs tonight. A few new ones. We're recording starting next week, a new album, and thank you very much, and here's a new song called Too Careful.
You can't be too careful. You can't lay an eyes over it. You can't be too careful. Skiing in Aspen, but you're a
Once again, I want to state that I think it's a great thing that the United Alternative people were gathering this weekend in Ottawa. You know, the other three right-wing reactionary parties just weren't, their platforms really weren't working for me, and I think I need a new party. And if that one doesn't work, I think a fourth party or fifth party should emerge. Until they, you know, because they just don't have the exact agenda that I want just yet. They're close.
Maybe a gang of people with brown short-sleeved shirts.
Right.
Okay,
I don't
understand.
Ooh, call them the wigs.
Still offering, still unofficially, of course, offering Fruvous paraphernalia for renegade activist attacks on the United Alternative people. But that's completely unofficial. That's a rumor that I've heard.
Actually, you can get a little budgie dog that spits rubber bullets. That's hilarious. It's beat.
That's right. And the bullets actually are kind of a nice sort of massage shower that when it hits you. But it still sends a message, you know.
It's symbolic.
Because the person doesn't actually get hurt, but they go, what is that? And then they go, I wish I wasn't right wing.
It's more just humiliating to be hit by one of those things.
That's right. Yeah.
Like no one wants to be seen being hit
of
that.
Course not. Being hit by a budgie dog.
I wouldn't want that, you know.
Bullets.
Right. Puff bullets.
That would be good. Puff bullets. I was attacked by a fungus here. I had a bruise.
The attack of the fungus is always quite among us. We're dancing all our rumbas to dodge the attack of the fungus. It's quite uncommon to go to the commons, hear common sense masquerading as said. It's quite unsaid that we're all governed by the Legion of the Undead.
Here's a song called Horseshoes.
Realize what you are. You keep hanging out for shoes.
that set it free. I said, you're on the scene, still you know to me. And I was satisfied, I was on my side, cause we're free and on the earth. She sent me a letter, I didn't read it, I already knew. Look straight at the common disaster.
Some people sleeping on the streets, I believe them. And that means, I mean, not the people on the streets, I believe that the economy is booming. I believe that everyone, surely everyone in this room, is doing just fine. And that means that you all will have had, a well-paying employer. That's right. We here at Moxy Fruvous, a pro-employer band.
That's right.
An anti-worker pro-employer band.
We are trying to put a happy face on downsizing.
That's right.
One day, a third of you will all be making shoes. In sweatshop conditions, and we just want to make that a little bit easier for you. Starting with this song.
Here's a song about working in a dog food store. That's right, a dog food store! Between the ages of 13 and 16 in Thornhill, Ontario, just north of Toronto. Maybe you can relate, probably not. Can't stand. What am I doing with these?
The X!
The X! Where am I?
And who are you people? And what are you staring at?
What are these hot white things in my mouth? Anyways, it's funny.
Last thing I remember, I was in a dentist chair.
You may have ways of making you love your boss.
He can't stand a loss, he's always cross, his name is Ross, mine. I love my boss, I love my boss, he isn't full of fluff and gloss. He gives me work and many chores to do. My model, I've been bar track to a hoss. And though he pays me minimum wage, it's all that deserves at this stage. Some union hacks that I should ask for more. My answer was Susan will enrage. I love my boss. To work too late. I'd had a Fruvous luncheon date. My bossy summoned me to speak with him. I sweated, awaiting my fate. He said, you're done! He chased me too much with a gun. But my dear boss and me apologized. In hindsight, there wasn't a gun.
He's the boss.
Scotia Bay.
Bosses from the ages through, they're the ones who make it move. If you wish we'd have an empty plate, if it weren't for Larry Tate, Clark can't reach the highest height with the help of Perry White. And if we may be retrograde, speak the name Ruben Kincaid.
Is a pleasant one.
The Shoe Museum.
As an exhibit.
Is this machine VHS or platinum?
Well, you know, we some of you may know that we have a serious side in Moxy Fruvous, but but a lot of times, like especially when we first were getting known in Canada, people would harp on our, you know, oh, they're funster, goofy, you know. I mean, this is way in the past. They used to call us this like comedic a cappella folk group. The joke is that they called us that in the Globe and Mail yesterday, and we were like, wow, they still can't get over that. Although it was a very nice article, good work, and. So anyway, but one of the reasons I guess we've always stood out is because we've lived in this era, like, you know, in the 90s, where you know, the celebration of suicidal angst has been one of the main tenets of pop culture. And
with all due respect.
With all due respect to the Nine Inch Nails guy, who, you know, looks pretty cool, you know? Let's face it. But it's a drag, when, you know, so this is kind of partly what this song is about, a newer song called Sad Girl.
Sad girl, taking every cue from every actor. Hopelessness is easy when it's a fat girl. Taking every cue from passion is romantic when it's a fangirl.
Take you all on a little trip. That's right, to a land commonly known as cottage country. It's a spot, it might be the Kawarthas, it might be the Halliburtons. Wherever you are, you can get CKVR in cottage country. And you can also find...
When will it no longer be the new VR?
That's right. Mike just dated himself there. It's not CKVR anymore, is it? It's the new VR.
That's right. He set himself back a year.
He sure did. He's very, very, a lot older than the rest of us.
That's right.
Very, very older man.
You'll find my age in your missalettes. All right.
Mike, you're dark. Carl, do we have a light for Mike?
Back there. Oh, fuck. I mean, screw the light.
Can we get a light on Mike, please? I don't know why they can't get a light on you.
Have you got a spot?
Blast!
Just a spot for Mike. It'd be nice.
Well, what about, no, you know what? I don't think there actually is a light pointed in that direction, and,
anybody have a flashlight?
There we go.
The power of two Duracell 9 volts.
That's the way, you know what? Before all this technology existed for all these lights, that's the way they used to light shows with flashlights.
Candles, very well. Candles.
No, flashlights.
Oh, flashlights.
They used to call them footlights because they were attached to people's boots.
That's right.
I'll tell you what else is attached to my boot, fella. Central Ontario, cottage country, where you find a lot of lakes, a lot of mosquitoes, and a lot of frickin' Americans because you're trying to get away from the urban malaise that Mr. President Stoney Carter spoke of in the late 70s. The urban malaise that they try to escape when they get to cottage country, but they don't escape it completely because they're followed by one rapscallion of a character known as Pisco Bandito.
In Halliburton, near the Laika bays, lives a fish from a far away. He hates the weather, but still he stays. He hates the work, but he says it pays. He rots the people as they swim away. His little piece of the tourist trade. This little fella's really got it made. From May to mid-July, he's Pisco Bandito, open-air fish. He wants your money, he gets his wish. He swims away with the mighty swish. Pisco the Bandit Fish.
Hey!
He left his bandit down in Mexico to buy the waters of Ontario. He didn't want to, but he had to go. He sends the money every month or so. Swimming in the summer sun. Hunting videos of midnight run. Bandit's life is lots of fun. It's lots and lots of fun. Pisco Bandito, the bandit fish. If he wants your money, he gets his wish. If he swims away with a mighty swish, Pisco the bandit fish. What is Pisco's favorite thing to rob?
They say he likes apple strudel.
What does he do when not on the job?
On the guitar, noodle.
Ah,
strong, but he's no worse than Jean Valjean, except he drinks and carries on, and smashes bottles on the neighbor's lawn. The oceans and the seven seas are filled with many different tales like these. These are like you or me on the wrong side of the law. He's Pisco Bandito, the bandit fish. If he wants your money, he gets his wish. If he swims away with a mighty swish, Pisco the bandit fish. Pisco Bandito, the bandit fish. He wants your money, he gets his wish. If he swims away with a mighty swish, Pisco the bandit fish.
We're so fortunate to have such wonderful musical friends back in Toronto, and we'd like to invite the absolutely amazingly talented Sarah Slean up to play some tunes with us.
We get to play a song that's on Sarah's CD, which is available here, and some proceeds also going to the OCAC, part of the proceeds from the CD, and well worth it to get Sarah's CD, and this is certainly my favorite song on it, and we're going to do our version, we're going to wreck it.
We're going to wreck Sarah's too.
It's a really cool song, and we're going
to,
you know.
Did Kevin have to go? Did we?
He did, the last
fairy
is 11, forgot
that it's
Sunday.
Oh, it's Sunday.
It's
the last fairy of the week. Fairy of the week. It's the last song he'll ever sing with Sarah.
No, I mean today was, that was the last one he was going to sing today. Tomorrow's a new day.
That was really awful.
You know,
he said,
just stop. I'm going to stop speaking now. On behalf of Sarah, I'm offended by that shit. That's better.
This is a song about an angel that Sarah once hired.
Thank you.
Feels pretty bad, doesn't it? You want to split it, Murray? Go for it.
I just don't. I know the middle part, so you start.
Go ahead, Murray.
I can't rap and bust a move, so you gotta choose.
I just want
to bust a rhyme, man. Bust a rhyme.
It's disgusting.
Maybe I'll just rock the mic.
Well, this is, why don't you tell the story of this one?
We travel around the United States of America quite a bit. And we find that it's just like Canada. In a lot of ways.
As much as we
sorry, don't. It's nice to say that we're so different, but we aren't. We're the same flesh and blood.
Is that an American style of dance I was doing?
It was the same style of dance. Same the world round. You know, it's like a Janet Jackson video, man. You travel the world with your... When I say vibology, I mean it in a funky way. And you've got it covered. So we travel around. And sometimes we feel that when we're traveling in the States, we're looking into, in some places, the future. Our future. And I fear that's probably the case when we look at the Michigan Militia.
Fencing up this little piece of heaven. can tell you, Trisha, that we won. You'll be ecstatic, looks like an match told me up in the attic. That was your wish again, to be packing for a bad wish again. Down, down.
The farm.
Choice benefit for the OCAC, but it's actually the sixth year. We actually started in 94, so it went 94, 95, 96, 98, 99, and 97. We couldn't find the time to do the choice benefit because we were involved, heavily involved in Toronto at the time with the No to the Megacity campaign. Some of you may remember that. Seems like so long ago, doesn't it? Now that we're all just happy in our megalopolis. So, part of what was happening at that time, though, was a reaction amongst citizens of Toronto and other cities and people across Ontario against the myopic sort of cutbacks of and right-wing politics of the Harris government. I won't get into it because I know we're going to be preaching to the converted here, but what I will say is that if there's anything good that's come out of what the Harris government has done to this province in the last few years, it's perhaps that it's crystallized a movement of people who realize what they believe in their province and have a sense of what we find dear in our province and what we want to preserve. And who are willing to fight for it. And even maybe, as ridiculously overstated as it was, the Martin budget is a reaction, with healthcare spending, is a reaction to people saying, hey, this is enough. Anyway, this is a song that we wrote at the time and that we gave to the movement and that continues to be relevant, we think, and it's a song called Today's the Day That We Fight Back.
So very slick with the deficit arithmetic. Hospital shut down real quick, so you best be sure you don't get sick. That's the Harris Tory shtick. Cutbacks stop the people snore. Clinics had to close their doors. Anesthetics cost too much. So whack yourself with a 2x4. You might have thought there can't be more, but that's not all they're asking for. Wall Street. Wall Street. Starting with fair common sense, but things for teachers got real tense. Students saw tuition soar, obstacles became immense, and no care for the consequence. McDonald's teach grade free, but Exxon run university. TVO has got to go, and we can't afford your local library. Sell your bed, sleep on the floor, but that's not all they're asking for. Wall Street calls on Bay Street then. Bay Street calls their Queens Park friends. Turn welfare into extra men. That's how they bought the government. Education is no priority. Make your mind an employee of their dirt cheap work, fair core.
with Bill 103, cause there is strength and unity. Strength to shut the people off and whittle down democracy. Download, upload, 1, 2, 3. Surely realize the plan is to demoralize. Stay at home and watch the game and bow down to free enterprise. Be governed by the banker's whore, but that's not all they're asking for. If you'd like to escape it all, there's a holiday to take this fall. A weekend in Tamagami, chained up to a big old tree. Soul. It's a global ticker tape attack, but today's the day that we fight back. It's a global ticker tape attack, but today's the day that we fight back. Today's the day that we fight back. Today's the day that we fight back.
GTA, Greater Toronto Area, South Central Ontario. Always plowing over, always burying, filling in another nice ravine area. Except for up in the Rouge, where they just saved a little bit in exchange for some fine housing. And luckily, we have the memories of the ravines we once traversed, smoked a cigarette in, kissed a tree in rehearsal.
In rehearsal for the big tree wedding.
I am the stately oak who grows in the forest.
And I am the feminine dogwood who would be my wife.
Please blossom and pepperworth at your service.
See the tree wedding at Theatre Passepartout next week. Brought to you by CBC. Oops.
Will this melding of hardwood realize its potential? Can conifer and deciduous find true love?
Bruce? If that's Bruce Beaton back there, raise your hand. Okay.
He looks like him, though.
He does, it's not Bruce.
So!
All right, then.
Jenny, if that's Jenny Jones, raise...
Oprah, is that you? Here's a song about the very present tense.
Circumstances eat themselves, the present tense has been. Fill the fancy bowl up at the present tense tureen.
I once had a girl, she lived in the past, and it was clear that relationship wouldn't last. It was clear from the way she had to sleep south. It was clear from the lines around her mouth. So I went for the walk in the ravine. I came up on an unbelievable scene. In the tiny creek, there's a tiny boat with a tiny man in a tiny boat. I said, hey man, do you think you can help? He said, of course I can. Just fictional device. We sail ravines and give advice. I said, my baby is on its about. He cried, help to leave. Boy, I'm coming about. Don't fill me in
on right or wrong.
Take these ropes and sing this song.
Circumstances eat themselves. Present tense has been. Fill the fancy bowl up at the present tense terrain.
His eyes were afire, he lit up a coal. He handed me a ladle and a little white bowl.
Right on the fire,
he opened the book. He said, sit down, things gotta cook. That's the loveliest part. seen. He said it's not a pot, it's a tureen. And what's inside will make you well. So ring this little dinner bell. Then he giggled in French, that's what he did. Like a kid at Christmas as he opened the lid. Help yourself, he beamed with pride. There was no sweet soup inside. The silence fell on the cooling night. I thought I'd better make it just to be polite. Smallest rim, biggest moon.
Empty bowl, empty spoon. Circumstances eat themselves, the present tense has been. I feel the fancy bowl up at the present tense tureen.
Every minute though,
circumstances eat themselves, the present tense has been.
Taking over the room earlier tonight, please welcome Susan Werner.
I have to say that shirt sets off your eyes really well.
Susan, are you threatened, as an American female singer-songwriter, are you threatened by the Canadian invasion of Celine Dion and Shania Twain?
They just have better brow lines. That's what they're doing.
Don't count. Dave, I have to say, you're so well appareled tonight. Finally, someone on the stage brings just a hint,
a
soupçon of class.
A class, yeah,
this band.
A soupçon. You know what? If you look really closely, Dave's wearing cufflinks. Holding this, you know, the old 70s way to hold the shirt together? Cufflinks.
Tie clips, the whole thing. I've got garters on, actually.
You've got those sock garters.
Hose. He's wearing hose.
But keep the socks up like you had in Scouts. Dave's got those on.
and I'm like, oh, what? He said, do that one old tune, that one old tune, that one really old tune. You're going to let us sing it. to understand that everything's a war act tonight. You're worried you're gonna have it, everything's okay. Imagine this, your daddy's rich and your mommy's good looking. So hush, hush the baby
better than having Susan Werner on stage, and that's having Susan Werner and the banjo on stage. You can go to those other Rock for Choice gigs, but will Pearl Jam be bringing out the banjo? I think not. And I love Pearl Jam.
Okay, rock around, everybody. She was a fast machine to get the motor clean, to put the best damn motor I ever seen. The ass had those eyes telling me no lies. Those American guys taking more than the share. Fighting for years. Told me that my mind was already there. Got the bones was shaking. Earth was working, my mind was sinking. You are making it. You shook me all night long. Yeah, you shook me all night long. Working double time. I was a ocean line. She was one of a kind. Just mine on mine. Had to cool it down. Take another round. Back in the wind to take another swing. Got the wall was shaking. Earth was quaking. My mind was sinking. And we were making it. You shook me all night long. Yeah, singing you shook me all night long.
Let me tell you a story about a man named Jed. Poor my nigga, big friend Jed. And I came shooting as a cruder. Threw a gown, came a rolling through. Oh, that is. And it's like rain on your way. Yeah, goodbye. Oh, what a great goodbye. Thanks for this thing to take. And who would have thought it began?
I'm young, but I'm honest. I'm strong, but I'm chicken shit.
Yeah!
so much to admit that it's time we're aware it's a small world after all. Here we go, everybody!
It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all.
Give it to Susan Werner!
Sartorial king,
a united alternative.
And now I work at the pizza, pizza.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Train, not in a car, not up a tree.
tree, cause I don't bite them, Sam. See, not in a schoolhouse, but a shoebox, a house mouse, a red fox, got here and there and everywhere, dare, even like the Beatles with the long, long hair.
Not the Beatles. Not the Beatles. Dr. Henry Morgenthaler is here, and he, not only is he an incredible man who's done a lot of progressive things, but he used to, word has it, he used to, you know, do a little partying with John Lennon. And you have some audacity.
Funny, I heard a story about him rodeoing for John Lennon.
You have some, okay, fine. Fine, let's say he did.
Let's say he rodeoed for John.
Yeah, and then you come out here at an OCAC benefit, a pro-choice benefit, and with him in the room, and you attack the Beatles. You're a bad man.
So we should make fun of roadies then. According to you, we should make fun of roadies. According to you then, we should make fun of Toby. Toby, come on up on stage here.
Toby's coming. Why do you hate Toby? You hate Toby.
We're gonna, you know what we're gonna do? You know what we're gonna do?
Toby.
You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna beat Toby to within an inch of his life and make you watch.
That's right. That's perfect. That's perfect.
Poor Toby. Toby's crying.
Poor defenseless Toby.
Toby.
Oh my God.
Everything.
Kill Dave. Kill him.
It's so.
Hey, you don't. Listen. Hang on a second here.
Wait a second.
You don't like
Yeah, no, it's WWF all of a sudden.
You don't like Green Eggs and Ham.
Oh, Mr. Perception, Sam, I am.
But I'm the one that's lucky to be eating with a ghost.
I would not put not with a ghost.
Well, would you put you on the ghost?
I would not put not on a boat, and I will not never with a ghost. I'm not interested in stomach face in the rain of a train. I should never lose my memory. Bang! Out of the dark! I never take none of my China with no brain. No boxes, boxes, houses, 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 and what?
No spouses!
What are you trying to make me that don't like it? I wouldn't feed it to my goodness. I don't like them, Sam, I am. I do not like Green Eggs and Ham!
Mr. Cheese, you just think you don't like them, so you say it. You begin to throw my damn daughters, they have to get them. And you don't like that, wait, it's gonna sound like a fanny again. Just try them. And you may find you like nothing better than two British eggs, all easy in the fry pan. And two of them better than this fine taste, we have marsh and ham.
What from space? Sam! If you get out of my face, I'll try that. I'll puke all over the place. It makes a crowd disperse more quick than a great big puddle of sick.
He's gonna try them. 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 He's gonna try them.
Distributor cap, I'll snap them on as it rides through.
six Merc's ride through. I can drive, and she can drive, but this car's made for you. I'd like to buy the one.
Where are you, my son?
I'd like to buy her two.
But you know what, right, you three?
I'd like to buy her three.
When working at a factory,
and I'd like to buy her.
One of these Swedish fellas we got over here.
I'd like to buy a three. I'd like to buy a four.
In Darlington lies my darling one. She fills my thoughts each day. Half a mile from the cooling towers, I should hope that she's okay.
Sports!
I'd like to buy a one.
Where you gonna get the money, son?
And I'd like to buy a two.
Sarah Slean and Susan Werner for all being here, and we're gonna go record an album, and we hope to see y'all soon, and it's always great to play in Troy.
I didn't know if it was real.
Tastes like shit. But I still cook it up, you know, because I'm a man of principle. So I eat stuff that tastes like shit.
On principle.
Yeah. Actually, I've taken to eating at McDonald's. Because there's no meat in those burgers. So, you know, it's ethically correct and cheap. You know, and you get to support a small independent company.
Please up.
We figured things were up for a while, so we would settle down a little bit, and this is a song from our second album, Wood, and also was on our live album last year. It's a song called Fly.
Clean your mind, every little child learns.
such an antiquated passion. On the day they both conspired to ride the midway after dark, they had enough of their pride to not bring coins to this amusement park. And she held his hand to follow, and he held his breath and let go. They crashed down low, sat in the front row, untied the rope so they could burn. Hold on tight, let's get it just right. We'll take our last flight, you and I. So the crowd inside had their eyes smiled. There was no turning back for two. Erase the memory, stopped by all alone, and one thing left to do. In the roller coaster shadow, they took off their shoes and bared their souls. They crashed down low, sat in the front row, untied the rope so they could fly. Hold on tight, hold on tight,
get it just right.
And come on now, let's get it right.
Take our last flight,
take our last flight, you and I. And she held his hand to follow, and he held his breath and let go. They crouched down low, sat in the front row, untied the rope so
very much. We were back there trying to think of what to do.
We thought of something, actually.
We're actually going to take you to the million and one basements of Thornhill, Ontario.
It's not a regular Fruvous gig, and so we thought we'd do something that we don't always do, and do a little jam.
Would you like to jam? Would you like that?
She's still
Thank you.
While the planning has begun for the 6th annual Fruvous and Friends for Choice, and confirmations on John Tesh
and Richard Carpenter.
Richard Chuck Carpenter and the Captain from Captain and Tennille.
Yes, he is the Captain.
But I'm doing a duet.
And the surprise special guest is Don Henley. And I spoil the surprise.
I'm Oates.
And also Helen Reddy. Well, we would like for those diehard Helen Reddy fans, she will be back here with Tesh, Henley, and the Captain next year. Sorry?
Jewel?
She's not allowed to cross the border,
likely.
Actually.
Yeah. Not likely.
She's got a rap sheet, like, as long as her arm.
No.
She can't cross the border, sorry.
Free trade has gone way too far, but not that far.
I'm sure she's a fine person. Like, you know, it should be said. But, the lyrics.
What's the lyrics?
My hands, they are my hands. They're not your hands, they're my hands.
My hands, they are mine. They are just mine. They are not yours.
Whatever she's getting at, I agree. They are her hands. I don't want her hands.
But she's... John Tesh doesn't even write lyrics, does he? Does he? What do you mean you have the right here? John Tesh is a multi-million selling,
He's North America's Yanni.
He plays piano, right?
He's North America's Yanni, basically.
What about, Yanni is North America's Yanni. He's Yanni, because he's North America.
He's a niche market Yanni.
Yanni's a bad cop?
Cops, all right.
Well, thanks, everybody, once again. We're going to end with a song that we sometimes end our shows with. It's a song from our first record, Bargainville, and it's an opportunity to sing along if you feel like it. It's a song called The Drinking Song.
And the band played on as the helicopters were drunk on the my senses are blurred. He was a rock. To the end, a solid reminder. Couldn't deny a friend. We lived in the noise of sweet amber poison. Picking up the skirt of the end. And we drink. Between poles, he said, we're like cows in the grass, brushing off flies. She's lounging around, standing up, falling down, till we no longer open our eyes, and we drink. Troops are the cause to the end of our
passed out on the sun deck that morning, quietly saying goodbye. But I was so hammered, I sputtered and stammered. Told him he couldn't just die. He was a robin. Went straight for his own Armageddon. Face frozen.
Thank you.